In the name of Allah, who is the most beneficent and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum to all of you. Today the topic under discussion is biofuels. It is very important topic in today's scientific point of view. First of all, I'll tell you about its history. Since human discovered fire, charcoal, wood chips and cattle dung have been used as a source of energy by human for different purposes like heating, cooking and etc. Rudolf Virchow was the first scientist who used peanut oil to generate power. He also used vegetable oil for energy production. He developed first working engine that runs on peanut oil. Then we come towards biofuels. Because of its different features like renewability and biodegradability and high useful ability of these biofuels, they were greatly used by their demand became greater day by day in today's world. Now come towards its advancement. Different advancement comes in this topic. First of all, first generation biofuels were synthesized there, then next second generation and next third generation. Up till now, different generations have performed their work accurately, and the coming generation is more powerful and more helpful as compared to that of the previous generation. Now we will study from its first generation biofuel and which advancement comes in it and how it leads to second generation and how it leads to third generation and so on. Now I'll explain its advancement, different advancement that comes in this field, in this biofuels are as follows. Advancement include, first of all, first generation biofuels. First generation biofuels were mainly ethanol. How it is synthesized? It is synthesized by different food crops that undergo fermentation, and fermentation is, all of you know, fermentation is done by different microorganisms or macroorganisms. Then it leads to ethanol production. Means different food crops were used, and these food crops include sugar cane, sugar beet, maize, rice, etc. So these different food crops were going to use, which leads to fermentation, and then this fermentation result in ethanol production. So this is a synthesis. Now the reasons behind its synthesis are different. Different reasons include that ethanol production demand is becomes greater day by day. That's why it is going to synthesize by this process. So first reason is increase in demand. Second is it protect national security. It support rural development. It support agriculture, industries, and it reduces greenhouse gases emission. So these were different reasons behind its increase in production. Now different disadvantages were there. As the food crops were going to use, so it leads in high food prices. Food prices going to increase. Moreover, it require high production cost. So high food prices means as food crops were used here, and this compete with human food crops, it leads to increase in food prices. So another disadvantage is competing with food crops. It has a strongly adverse effect on agriculture worldwide. Strong adverse effect on agriculture worldwide. Then, so due to these disadvantages, it becomes very difficult to continue its production from these food crops. And different first generation biofuels include ethanol. These may be syngas, biogas, biobutanol, etc. So these were different first generation biofuels. Now come towards second generation biofuels. Second generation biofuels, as food crops were directly used by human in first generation biofuels, but in second generation biofuels, non-food crops were going to use, and these include lignocellulosic compounds. Then this process was classified into two different categories on the basis of the process used. This may be biochemical or this may be thermochemical process. Now its synthesis is from non-food crops. Result in biofuels. Now come towards its classification. It is classified into two major categories, which are as follows. First one is biochemical. Biochemical, and second one is thermochemical. Both of these you can gain help from flowsheet diagram. I'll draw it for you. Flowsheet diagram. Okay, first of all, in biochemical process, biomass is taken. It is then passed through a pre-treatment, which is the first step. Pre-treatment is done. What is pre-treatment? Pre-treatment means that first of all, different treatments were carried out, and these include separation of cellulose, hemicellulose, lignin, and other different food items. is after separation, then carbohydrates will be converted into sugars. Then it becomes easy to ferment sugars into biofuels. So after pre-treatment, which is the first step, second step is that it is passed through scarification. And ultimately passed through fermentation. Here enzymes enzymes are used, and both of these are considered as biochemical processes. From here, biofuel is gained. Hence, from this biochemical process, biofuels can be synthesized from biomass. And this biomass is food residues, means not directly food crops, but these are actually raw materials. They are raw materials of food crops. Now we will draw a flow sheet diagram of thermochemical process. Okay. For thermochemical process, different first step is purification. Purification is carried out. Purification, or we can say it is gasification. What is done in gasification? In gasification, this biomass is converted into gas form, means that the biomass is burnt at high temperature and at high pressure, and it leads to gaseous substances production. And then these gases are then further cleaned by different mechanisms. For example, they are removal of carbon dioxide is carried out from this whole mixture of gases, and then after removal of carbon dioxide, then this gas is called as syngas, or it is called as clean gas. And clean gas contains carbon monoxide, methane, and other different gases, useful gases. Then carbon monoxide and hydrogen are further catalyzed by different catalytic processes, and they are converted into biofuels. So first is purification, and after purification, what is done? This is done as removal of carbon dioxide. Removal of carbon dioxide, and removal of carbon dioxide result in the production of syngas. Okay, this is syngas, and this syngas contains carbon monoxide, hydrogen, methane mixture. Okay, and these carbon monoxide and hydrogen are then further catalyzed by catalytic process and result in biofuels. Okay, this is flow sheet diagram for thermochemical process. Basic difference is that here in thermochemical process, therm word is used for temperature. So here biomass is heated at high temperature and high pressure. Then we come towards its advantages and its disadvantages. Advantages include again the same thing that advantages include that because here non-food crops are used, so this is its basic advantage. Now there will not be competition between among food crops, and food prices will not be rises too much as in the previous case where food crops were going to use, and so their prices were going to increase day by day. And the disadvantage include because the biomass is heated at high temperature and high pressure, this leads to air pollution. So air pollution result in different diseases, different human diseases that include respiratory diseases, etc. Now final is third generation biofuel. Now come towards third generation. Third generation biofuels. Third generation biofuels include algae biomass. In this algae biomass is converted into biofuel. This algae biomass is very helpful because most of the algae are contain 80% of oil of their dry weight. So they contain oil, and this oil is used for making biofuels. And this process is very a lot of advantages. For example, if we consider, first advantage is that these algae can double their biomass. Algae can double their biomass in less than 24 hours. In less than 24 hours. Okay? Means it is going to double in less than 24 hours, and so it is very helpful for biofuels production. Second thing is that algae can be grown in wastewater, which so we do not need special purified water for its production, and this is very important benefit. Can be grown in wastewater or non-potable water. Third one is that it decreases much of greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases emission. These are its advantages. So on the basis of this, algae biomass is converted into biofuels, and it is very much profitable as compared to first generation and second generation biofuels. Okay, and the different techniques that were used here, that include techniques were, as earlier I said, biochemical, which is going to use in second generation, this is also used in third generation, biochemical and then thermochemical. Then is chemical. So these are different techniques that are going to use. And in spite of this, direct combustion can also be carried out. Mean algae biomass direct combusted. All of these techniques result in different types of biofuels, bioethanol, biobutanol, and other different types of products that were very helpful in biofuels. Now we came towards conclusion. What's conclusion of the overall topic? Conclusion is that biofuels demand increases day by day. Because fossil fuels that are non-renewable sources, and they are going to decrease at an alarming rate. So here this is a very important situation to meet the the fossil fuels deficiency with biofuels production. So biofuel demand is going to increase day by day at an alarming rate. And the second thing is that biotechnology plays a very important role here. So by the help of biotechnology, we can use different engineering techniques for plants, and to gain high yield of plants as well as high yield of biofuels. So with advancement in biotechnology, it becomes very helpful to synthesize more biofuels than our demands, and this is expected soon it will happen. Okay, students, thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.